can a single decision influence the future of the aviation industry and our planet? Recently, the United States Congress made a controversial move with potentially far-reaching implications for the aviation industry and climate change. At the center of this debate is Boeing's well-known 767 wide-body aircraft, which is now under scrutiny for its environmental impact. The Boeing 767 freighter variant has recently been granted an exemption from the new U.S. Federal Aviation Administration efficiency rules set to take effect in 2028. This decision carries significant weight, raising some critical questions about its impact on the future of aviation and the global fight against climate change. Why was this exemption granted, and what are the broader implications for environmental sustainability and industry standards? First, let's look at the context around this decision. The FAA introduced new efficiency rules aimed at reducing the environmental impact of airplanes. These rules are part of a broader effort to combat climate change by ensuring new aircraft designs meet higher fuel efficiency standards. The rules are also part of a broader set of international standards mandating cleaner engine types beginning in 2028. Under International Civil Aviation Organization, ICAO agreements, commercial aircraft manufacturers can't sell airplanes that don't meet the 2028 carbon emission standards. The U.S. Environmental Protection Agency, EPA, adopted the fuel efficiency standards in 2021, with the FAA following suit. Aviation is a significant contributor to global carbon emissions, accounting for around 3% of total emissions. Older aircraft like the Boeing 767 are less fuel efficient and produce more emissions compared to newer aircraft models. To understand the significance of the 767, it is important to look at its background. The Boeing 767 was first introduced in 1982 and has been in continuous service since that time. It was designed as a medium to long-range wide-body and has widely been used by airlines around the world for both passenger and cargo operations. Its freighter variant, the 767 freighter, has become a mainstay in the cargo industry, renowned for its capacity, reliability, and relative efficiency as a twin-engine wide-body airliner. Its size, range, and versatility make it ideal for transporting a wide variety of goods across the globe. This makes it a vital asset for companies relying on air freight. And something that we think is vital is your support of this channel. By subscribing to cleanearth.io, you're helping us to grow our platform as well as improve what we do here. And if you want to support us even further, check out our Patreon page. Your financial support will allow us to acquire the tools, resources, as well as gain access to clean tech and e-mobility related events so that we can plan and deliver even more great content. We'd simply appreciate it. To understand the significance of the 767 in the current market, with airlines adding newer and more efficient aircraft to their fleets, it's important to look at the 767's production numbers. As of the end of 2023, Boeing delivered a total of 40 Boeing 767 aircraft, reflecting its ongoing demand and pivotal role in both the commercial and freight sectors. This production figure underscores the model's sustained popularity and operational importance despite emerging environmental concerns. Major operators of the 767 freighter include three of the world's largest freight and logistics companies, UPS, FedEx, and DHL, highlighting the Big Twin's importance in each of these companies' global logistics and supply chain operations. Traditional cargo airlines opt for used 767s that have been converted to a cargo configuration because they don't have the consistent daily volumes of multimodal integrated express carriers like DHL and FedEx, and can't afford more expensive new models. UPS was the launch customer for the Boeing 767 freighter in 1995. The logistics giant has 88 767-300s in its fleet, including 10 converted freighters and 19 additional factory aircraft on order from Boeing. FedEx has 137 767s in its fleet, with 15 more new deliveries scheduled through mid-2026. The new rules were set to take effect in 2028, potentially phasing out older, less efficient aircraft, which include the Boeing 767 freighter. However, Congress recently granted an exemption to Boeing, allowing them to produce the type for 5 years beyond this deadline. The rules specifically include language allowing Boeing additional time to produce 767 freighters for FedEx and UPS. Unsurprisingly, FedEx and UPS put pressure on Congress to keep the Boeing 767 freighter option available to ensure continuity in their operations and competitiveness. The availability of secondhand 767s for conversion is drying up because passenger airlines like Delta and United are holding on to their aircraft longer than anticipated. The decisions by these airlines are in response to supply chain, manufacturing, and engine-related problems that have delayed delivery of replacement aircraft. The airlines probably won't be ready to let go of their 767s until they are due for retirement, meaning they are no longer airworthy or not worth the cost of conversion. The decision by Congress has sparked a lot of debate. On one hand, the exemption helps Boeing maintain production and support jobs in the aviation industry. On the other hand, it raises concerns about the environmental impact and commitment of the aviation sector to reducing carbon emissions. The aviation industry is under immense pressure to reduce its carbon footprint. Continued production of less efficient aircraft like the 767 freighter could slow down progress toward greener aviation. There are newer and cleaner aircraft solutions like the Boeing 787 and Airbus A350. Both aircraft are designed with advanced aerodynamics and more efficient engines, significantly reducing fuel consumption and emissions. Boeing is considering developing a freighter version of its 787 Dreamliner to replace the 767 freighter. The company has not yet made a definitive decision, but sees potential value in the 787 as a successor. The 787 freighter could be available sometime between 2028 and 2033, but with Boeing's current issues involving its 737 MAX family, 787, and 777X, we're unlikely to see a 787 freighter variant until the mid-2030s at the earliest. The Airbus A350 freighter is expected to enter service by 2025, targeting the market for long-haul cargo operations. This model is likely to exceed the requirements in terms of costs and capabilities for many air cargo operations. Despite more efficient aircraft options, the Boeing 767 freighter offers lower acquisition and operating costs compared to larger freighters, suitable for carriers needing flexibility and lower initial investment. Additionally, there's a growing interest in sustainable aviation fuels, or SAF, which promises to further decrease the environmental impact of aviation. but production costs of the fuel type are high and are insufficient to support the operational requirements of major cargo air carriers. So, what are the implications of this exemption? Industry experts believe that under the international fuel efficiency standards, non-compliant aircraft like the 767 will be prohibited from flying outside the United States, but there is no universal enforcement mechanism under the rules. ICAO's carbon emission standard will be implemented by individual countries as they update their domestic regulations for certifying aircraft types. The 767 freighter will essentially be banned starting in 2028 because non-compliant models will not be certified for sale by civil aviation authorities in their areas of jurisdiction. Countries that ban the sale of non-compliant models are likely to ban aircraft with an exemption from entering their airspace on the basis of having an unfair advantage. But aviation industry experts believe that FedEx and UPS access to airspace in foreign countries would depend on what individual governments are willing to accept. Smaller countries that typically follow FAA and European Union aviation regulations, rather than certify aircraft themselves, might have fewer issues with allowing exempted 767s to operate inside their airspace. Broadly, will this action by the U.S. Congress and other governing bodies around the world lead to more exemptions in other industries, potentially hindering progress towards environmental goals? Also, will it encourage other businesses and manufacturers to seek similar exemptions, creating a loophole that undermines global climate commitments? And if so, what does it mean for our collective efforts to combat climate change? As we navigate these complex issues, it's important to consider the long-term consequences of the exemptions, like the one granted to the Boeing 767 freighter. Striking a balance between economic growth and environmental responsibility is not just a necessity, but a moral imperative that is likely to have a major influence on climate action and how effectively it can be carried out. Looking ahead, the aviation industry faces a critical challenge to innovate and adopt cleaner technologies while balancing economic interests. The path to decarbonizing aviation won't be easy, but it is necessary for a sustainable future. As always, thanks for watching this video. And for more videos like this from the definitive source for clean tech, e-mobility, and sustainability, make sure that you like and that you're subscribed to cleanearth.io.